Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a while if you've actually been paying attention. Been about a month and a half since I filmed anything, and that's really because I was getting so close to having the final copy of my upcoming book, Tower of Dogs, coming out in January, but I was ordering proof copies like this week. So I guess I'll touch on two quick update changes before I jump into the core of the video. The first, kind of piggybacking on what I just said, I realized over the first half of the year that I was focusing so much on video content, and, or at least getting videos out, that I wasn't as productive creatively as I could have been. I still was doing really well, but I think the added stress really didn't help me at all. And then the second update is primarily regarding the book reviews that I am going to do moving forward. So with primarily doing independent publishers, new authors, I do want to promote them more. Sorry if you hear sounds in the background, that's the puppies again. Reviews are important, and I think the core of my videos is still gonna be a review because it is gonna reflect my opinion no matter what. But regardless if I liked a book or not, I still wanna promote it more than anything. So we're kind of move away from star ratings and just go into whether or not I think it fits on my bookshelf, and then you guys can decide if it fits on yours. So without further ado, let's jump into the book promotion review for Pip Coombs, The Hunted and A Night Rises. So The Hunted and A Night Rises are the first two books in the Phoenix series by Pip Coombs. She's an Australian author. I discovered her through YouTube, doing writing vlogs, promoting her books. And initially, I will admit, initially I wasn't sure what her books were about. I didn't read the blurb. This is something I am, like, I gotta get better on doing this, but I didn't read the blurbs initially. But I had found her books on Amazon. I added them to a future book list, and I kind of left it there for a while. Came back, and I was looking for books to, you know, independent author books to review, something I could buy on the Kindle, relatively cheap. Starting to read it, I realized, A, it's the Phoenix series, not because it's about Phoenix mythology with the fiery bird and everything, which the other reason I thought it could be that was because the cover of this first book is a bird. It's got that bird, it's got that nice ethereal, like smoky watercolor. It looked like a bald eagle, which was another reason I was a little bit confused, but regardless of what the bird was, I thought it was about Phoenix mythology, not witches and wizards. So going into that now, I need to read the blurb. So while I read the description that is on Goodreads, I'm gonna just throw the covers up there and look at my screen so you don't gotta worry about that, all right? A son will be born, forever hunted, forever bound. An island created by death, alive with magic and filled with creatures and beings trapped in an eternal clash, will welcome a new son who has been sheltered and hidden from the world he is destined to be a part of. William Phoenix will arrive at the Orphelia Academy of Magic and begin to uncover all that has been hidden from him. He will soon discover that his friends' lives and the fate of all those on the island depend on his survival. When his friend Penelope Elderson learns of the prophecy that marks him as a target, she will have to decide how best to protect him, to leave him in the dark, or to warn him of all that is coming before he is ready. Marked by violet eyes and with blood on his hands, William will fight the prophecy he has been cursed with. Those who seek to spill his blood will hunt him, only needing the whisper of a chance to get to him. Reading the description, I did actually read it before starting the book, so I was like, oh, this is about magic and not phoenixes. Phoenix, plural, whatever. So I had an idea, a smidgen of what we were getting into, but I really didn't get the feel of it until I was about two or three chapters in, where we're in William's POV. He's kind of living an average life, learns that he's a wizard, and then he is sent to the Orphelia Academy, where he is enrolled as a regular student. He's at the age of 17 at the point. So while this is a magic school, yes, it is screaming Hogwarts, Harry Potter, and the beautiful way that it was written definitely screams that, but in a very mature way. I have read the Harry Potter books before. I did love them. I love the detail. I know that's kind of an issue for some people right now because of the author, but whether or not that is, if you still want that type of world, that magic, that immersion into wizardry and witchcraft, then I think you will love this series for sure. So you definitely get immersed into that sort of world right away. Initially, I thought there might have been a little bit too much exposition as he was meeting Penelope and her brother on the bus. It just seemed like we were getting a lot of information for William's sake before we even like got into the story. However, as the story progresses, you want that information. You want to know all those side deals. You want to know more about these characters, which I love. So Miles is my favorite. He's sort of like the comedic relief of the group, but he's constantly bullied by another character named Max, and then he gets back at him, he gets in detention. It's a whole circle of things, and it's great. Penelope and her brother are on the bus when William is there, and he meets them first. He develops a really strong connection with Penelope, but it's always like kind of like two sides of a magnet that keep trying to come together, and they like diverge off because she gets in a relationship with one of the other friends, and then he's eventually promised to a different relationship because of who he is. Now, I will really quick say, I think it was obvious to the reader that William was the chosen one that the school and everybody kept talking about and waiting for. He didn't know, obviously, because he wasn't brought up in that world. So it made sense that he didn't know what was going on and he was upset about it, even though I think as a reader we're easily able to be like, well, that's the guy. Like, it has to be William. He's the main character. it screamed that he was the chosen one. Still works out though, because we follow his path, you know, not being comfortable in his new role, having to deal with other people's perceptions of him, being forced to, you know, become a protector but also be protected, so that conflict of, you know, when he can help and when he needs to step back. A lot of great things like that. Great friendships, as I said, and relationships, with the whole like romantic struggle that goes on. I thought it was dealt with very well. It did not feel like a high school drama. It wasn't like some catty fight going on. It was very, very deep, and it had multiple layers dealing with another person. It's not just because of that other person or that one thing that happened. It's because there's this going on with their brother or this going on with their mother. All these things going on, and I think everything wove together very well. I was very excited. This is one of the few books I've read this year where I didn't want to put it down and I wanted to just keep reading. It was an easy read. I thought it was well written. It was pretty clean. There might have been a few typos in the second copy, but I think the author was addressing those. And then my Kindle or the Kindle version when I downloaded it had an issue with page numbers, like the way that Kindle counted it. Because they kept like multiplying, but they would fall. The pages themselves wouldn't multiply, it was just the number. It'd be like, I was on 175 for three pages, and then I was on 178, so I was ending up on the correct page number. But anywho, I don't know what technical issue that was, but it was a thing, in case you notice it. Yeah, so covers are beautiful, the world building was so in depth and detailed, and I was excited about it. With the villain being a vampire lord, essentially, and his objective is to more or less a spell or a potion, I don't know what you'd like to call it, but he needs William, particularly his blood and his bones, to make himself fully immortal, and as a result, all of his descendants immortal, which they're already like semi-immortal, but at least you can kill them. So the clash between the wizards and the vampires are very interesting done. They have a little bit of a zombie, feral feel to them, the vampires. And eventually he does get some wolves on his side as well. So that's also an interesting little twist in the story. And I loved it. I really can't wait for the third one. I believe the third one's supposed to come out soon. The fourth one should be coming out whenever, but I believe she started working on it at least. So I'm excited overall, because I don't want this video to get too long and just spoil everything because I loved it so much and I need you guys to read it, that we can talk. Does this book, these books, get the shelf award? And the answer is yes, yes they do. So basically my shelf award is, if it's a completed series or a standalone, I'm buying that paperback. I'm more of a paperback person just because space. But essentially I want that book on my shelves because I feel like I'll reread it. So that's my 5-star equivalent, if you will. My only caveat to that is, with an ongoing series, I always want the series to be finished before I invest. So I will continue to support Pip Coombs with her Kindle versions, and I may order the first two soon, but I definitely want to see that third cover and possibly get that as well when it's released. So depending on how many books are in this series, I might have to buy the book sooner, but it definitely is going to end up on one of these shelves one day. I definitely enjoyed it. I do recommend it. I'm going to put links to the books on Amazon in the description, as well as Pip Coombs' YouTube. I'll do that, so you guys can check her out and follow her story, because she is very, very sweet, and she really is a good writer. So check it out. My recommendation, for whatever that means, and I do hope you enjoy it. So if you guys have written your own novel, or you know someone who has, that you want to support and kind of promote a little bit more, let me know. You can message me on Instagram or contact me. I think my email is in the description below, so you can do that as well. I do have another couple books lined up for review coming soon, and I'm excited when you guys reach out to me and ask me for a review, especially when, like, I have nothing going on this channel. So you guys are really helping me build it up and give it some quality content while I pursue my own novel. So it's been great. I really appreciate it. Again, contact me below, comment if you've read the book or if you'd like to read the book, and we can talk about it some more. Thank you guys again, and I will see you in the next video.